Assalamualaikum. I am Dr. Basva, resident of urology. Today, the topic of my presentation is small renal masses and the role of biopsy for the small renal mass. Why we are discussing this topic? Because the prevalence of small renal masses have been increasing and it is reached up to 42%. Most common presentation is no presentation, that 60% masses are present incidentally. And when we are talking about the management of small renal mass, we should think about the CKD, and not all small renal masses need surgical treatment. Introduction. Renal cell carcinoma accounts for 2 to 3% of all adult malignancy. RCC is the most lethal of the all urological cancers, and during the last 30 years, the incidence has increased by about 3 to 4% per year, reflecting an increase in the incidental detection of small masses with abdominal imaging, like ultrasound and CT scan. 20% of masses at presentation are metastatic, 25% present as locally advanced disease, and 1/3 of patients present with localized disease. These are the clinical presentation of RCC. They may present as incidental mass on abdominal imaging, and they may present with the symptoms of local tumor growth like hematuria, flank pain, or abdominal mass. They may present with metastatic symptoms or paraneoplastic syndrome symptoms. 20% of clinical T1 renal masses are benign, 60% are indolent cancer, and 20% are potentially aggressive cancer. The management option for T1 renal masses include active surveillance, thermal ablation, and surgical excision. When we discussing about the management of a small renal mass, we should think about the CKD, because after radical nephrectomy, the main concern is that it predisposes to chronic kidney disease, which can lead to cardiovascular events and increase mortality rates. A landmark study from Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center included 662 patients with a small solitary tumor, a normal opposite kidney, and a normal serum creatinine level. All patients underwent elective partial nephrectomy, and they noted that 26% of patient population had pre-existing grade 3 CKD, that is eGFR is less than 60 ml per minute. Why does this matter for our patient with kidney cancer? Because CKD is actually more common than we think among patients with renal cortical tumor. Baseline GFR may be associated with long-term survival, and nephron sparing approaches like partial nephrectomy and ablative procedures are associated with decreased risk of post-operative chronic kidney disease and adverse renal health outcomes. This graph shows that the decrease in GFR is associated with increased risk of cardiovascular events in CKD patients. And it shows that decrease in GFR is associated with increased number of mortality. Now, what is a small renal mass? The masses which are smaller than 3 to 4 cm in size and enhancing, and they should be localized to kidney. 43% of stage 1 tumor are less than 3 cm. Most but not all small renal masses are renal cell carcinoma. Overall, about 20% of solid enhancing clinical T1 renal masses are benign. The role of renal mass biopsy. The renal mass biopsy was abandoned in past due to the concern about false negative results and fear of complication. The diagnostic accuracy of renal mass biopsy in studies before 2001 averaged 82%, but now it increased to 90% in studies since 2001. The majority of these procedures can be performed in outpatient setting under radiographic guidance with minimal morbidity. The complications of mass biopsy include bleeding and needle tract seeding. Fewer than 1% of patients experience bleeding, leading to clinical intervention or hospitalization. Needle tract seeding is rare with well-circumscribed small renal mass, but it is a major concern with infiltrative renal masses, such as high-grade urothelial carcinoma. Indications of renal mass biopsy. include patients with non-extrarenal primary cancer, patients with imaging findings suggestive of unresectable renal tumor, patients with comorbidities in whom surgery is planned, and patients with renal mass that may be caused by infection, and to exclude the renal abscess from renal mass, patients with renal mass for which percutaneous ablation is considered, patients with radiologically indeterminate renal masses, and patient with multiple renal mass, and biopsy of a small renal mass is now emerging indication. Renal mass biopsy can be performed under local anesthesia with core needle or fine needle, under ultrasound or CT guidance with the same diagnostic yield. 18 gauge needles are ideal for core biopsies. Coaxial technique through coaxial cannula should always be used to avoid potential tumor seeding. In coaxial technique, the introducer needle is placed in the renal parenchyma and multiple biopsies are taken through the same tract. Core biopsies are preferred while a combination with FNA can improve accuracy. At least two good quality cores should be obtained and necrotic areas should be avoided. Peripheral biopsies are preferable for larger tumors to avoid area of central necrosis. In T2 renal masses, multiple core biopsies taken for at least four separate solid enhancing areas. Core biopsies of cystic renal mass have low diagnostic yield and are not recommended alone. Combined FNA and core biopsy can provide complementary results, especially for complex cystic lesions. The sensitivity of renal mass biopsy is 99.1% and specificity is 99.7%. These are the EUA recommendation of renal mass biopsy according to EAU guidelines. They strongly evident to perform a renal tumor biopsy before ablative therapy and systemic therapy without previous pathology. Perform percutaneous biopsy in select patients who are considering active surveillance, weak evidence. Use a coaxial technique when performing a renal tumor biopsy, strong evidence. Do not perform a renal tumor biopsy of cystic renal mass, strong evidence. Use a core biopsy technique rather than fine needle aspiration for histological characterization of solid renal tumor, strong evidence. These are different guidelines showing the indications of renal mass biopsy. According to ASCO guideline 2017, renal mass biopsy should be considered when the results may alter management. Consider when a mass is suggestive of lymphoma, metastasis, infection, or inflammatory. Not necessary before entering active surveillance protocols and should be performed before thermal ablative procedures. And according to this guideline, recommendation against renal mass biopsy are predominantly cystic renal mass, renal masses originating from the collecting system or suggestive of urothelial carcinoma. According to EUA guidelines 2017, renal mass biopsy should be considered when mass is suggestive of hemorrhagic, metastatic or infectious or inflammatory before thermal ablative procedure for pathological diagnosis and to guide surveillance. Consider after initial 3 to 6 months imaging with active surveillance for further risk stratification. Recommendation against renal mass biopsy according to AUA guidelines, young or healthy individuals unwilling to accept the uncertainties associated with renal mass biopsy, frail or older patients who will be managed conservatively regardless of the biopsy findings. According to NCCN guidelines, consider renal mass biopsy to obtain or confirm a diagnosis of malignancy and guide active surveillance and thermal ablative strategies. Consider if urothelial carcinoma is suspected or lymphoma hemogenous infiltration. And recommendation against renal mass biopsy are not discussed. According to EAU guidelines, all patients who are considered for active surveillance protocol and before thermal ablative procedures for pathological diagnosis and to guide surveillance. And recommendation against renal mass biopsy are cystic renal masses, comorbs or frail patient who will be managed conservatively regardless of the findings and not required if surgery is planned. This is the management algorithm of small renal masses. In this management algorithm, the patients are selected for renal mass biopsy according to patient characteristics and renal mass imaging characteristic. Patient characteristics include age, sex, comorbidity, renal function, or patient expectations, baseline quality of life, and psychological assessment. The small renal mass imaging characteristics include the size of the tumor, presence of necrosis, or anatomic complexity. According to biopsy finding, the patients are divided for the treatment of partial nephrectomy, thermal ablation, active surveillance, and watchful waiting. The patients who are candidate for thermal ablation, they assess for local recurrence. They should be assessed for local recurrence. If local recurrence is present, then repeat thermal ablation or surgery is advised. If no local recurrence is present, then continue surveillance. Patients who kept on active surveillance, they should be monitored for increase in tumor size, stage progression, or clinical signs of tumor progression. If they are present, then repeat biopsy is advised and treat according to biopsy findings. If there is low metastatic potential, then continue active surveillance. These are the histopathological results of article published in 2018 in British Journal of Urology. They perform core needle biopsy and then surgical biopsy of the same patients. And they found that all the suspected cases of oncocytoma on core biopsy were found that 65% of these patients have oncocytoma, while 13% have chromophobe renal cell carcinoma, 10% has clear cell renal cell carcinoma, 2% have unclassified, 6% has hybrid oncocytic chromophobe tumor, and 4% have other tumors. They concluded that the differences in these results may be due to the multivariant tumor or the operator dependent, because they did not get the proper tissue. These are results of different studies published in the same journal, and according to this these five studies have same histopathological results as of core needle biopsy and biopsy performed on surgical specimen. And these four articles show that the biopsy results are different from those performed on core needle and those performed on surgical specimen. This is another article published in July in 2018, and which emphasizes on indication, techniques, safety, and accuracy results of renal tumor biopsy and impact on the treatment decision management. And they concluded that the yield of biopsy is also operator dependent. In this study, they performed the biopsies of 129 patients, out of which 77 were malignant, 35 were benign, and 17 were inconclusive. Virtual biopsy of renal mass is a new emerging modality which uses imaging modality like CT scan and MRI to predict the histopathology of renal mass. In this technique, solid renal masses are divided into hyperintense, isointense, and hypointense categories on the basis of tumor symptoms, patient characteristics, and on the basis of CT scan and MRI. And then tumors are subdivided into histological subtypes on the basis of clear cell likelihood score, which was given according to patient characteristics, tumor characteristics, and imaging and on the basis of imaging findings. This is CT scan of 56-year-old male patient with left renal mass, and it shows homogeneous and progressively enhancing mass in the posterior medial left kidney, which is mildly hyperattenuating on the unenhanced image. Mass was favored to represent papillary renal cell carcinoma according to virtual mass biopsy, and patient underwent percutaneous renal mass biopsy also. Post biopsy CT scan was performed because patient reported pain, and this CT scan showed large perinephric hematoma, and patient was managed conservatively. Biopsy confirmed the diagnosis of papillary renal cell carcinoma, and after surgical resection, final diagnosis of type 1 papillary renal cell carcinoma was made. Small renal masses are clinical challenge as they range from benign to lethal. Genomic profiling may eventually improve treatment selection, but more research is needed. Why renal tumor biopsy was not advised? Because it was not advised in past due to the fear of seeding, delay in surgery, and radical surgery was the only curative option in the past. But now nephron sparing approaches, thermal ablation, and active surveillance were also the option. Now the paradigm shift towards the renal tumor biopsy. In the last couple of decades, the philosophies have been shattered for small renal mass. First with the introduction of nephron sparing surgery, then with minimal invasive techniques in the form of laparoscopy and robot-assisted surgery, and finally with the adoption of active surveillance and ablation therapy. Management is also becoming increasingly guided by coaxial renal tumor biopsy, now known to be safe and accurate technique. Factors to be considered for decision are patient characteristics, life expectancy, tumor size, location and histology, and surgical expertise. The harms resulting from both overdiagnosis and overtreatment are diverse, and there is now a greater focus on clinicians to both recognize these risks and to appropriately counsel the patients. Shared decision making and better patient selection tools will ultimately help in guiding treatment selection and in minimizing the morbidity in patients diagnosed with small renal mass. The conclusion is current evidence support using renal mass biopsy as a risk stratifying tool, and urologists are advised to incorporate this into their management scheme for small renal masses. Further implementation of a renal mass biopsy based algorithm would be enhanced with a well-designed prospective clinical trials. Overall, biopsy demonstrated a strong independent association with reduced use of surgery for clinically T1 kidney cancer, especially with increasing age and comorbidity. The potential association of renal mass biopsy with upstaging warrants caution, but it is uncertain whether it impacts prognosis relative to true perinephric fat invasion or not. These are the references. Now, this is the data showing this is the data of biopsies, image-guided biopsy of renal masses performed in SIUT from June 2019 to June 2020. Total number of biopsies performed were 82, out of which clear cell RCC clear cell variant 41, RCC papillary variant 6, RCC chromophobe variant 2, Ewing sarcoma 2, spindle cell carcinoma 1, sarcomatoid carcinoma 3. One is high-grade pleomorphic sarcoma, one TCC with foci of squamous differentiation, one germ cell tumor, one metastatic prostatic adenocarcinoma, one is infiltrating neoplastic lesion with squamous component, and two are of chronic granulomatous inflammation, while 19 biopsies are inconclusive. This is the graphical representation that 38% biopsies shows clear cell carcinoma, 17% are inconclusive, 2% are benign, and 43% of include other lesions.
You go back to the slide where you was presenting. You were presenting the this one. Right. So all these tumors were of which size? And why biopsy was opted?
They were not small masses.
Right. So this is a very interesting answer that you have given, because then there is an element of indication which are other than small renal masses for biopsy. Now this has been in the mind of a lot of us that we always take biopsy of a kidney of a lesion where we are in doubt whether this is something malignant, whether it is something which is of benign nature, or it is something which is infective. Now, if that question arises, then in order to have an answer, we always go for biopsy. That is one thing. The second thing is small renal masses. So if it is a small renal mass, then we always think that it might be benign and it might be possible that we might not go towards surgery. So we want to save a person from surgery. Third indication that is in our minds many a times is whether this tumor is a lymphoma or not. Because for lymphoma, the treatment of choice is chemotherapy, not surgery. So what you are telling from your data, and this is something which is quite incredible, is indications other than what we all already in the process of thinking. So this has to be, I think, this has to be a message to a lot of us who are involved in the process of diagnosing and treating the patients with renal masses. So whenever there is a doubt again, and there is a possibility that you want to go towards a new adjuvant chemotherapy, for instance, or immunotherapy prior to surgery, in the case of renal mass, then it has to be documented with biopsy first. So biopsy now is something, and this is a paradigm shift. This is a paradigm shift from whatever we have learned in the past in our residency programs. So this is a major change in the treatment of renal mass. So I think this is very important. The second thing is, I am taking your time. The second important thing which I have learned from my experience and my treating and managing these patients in the past 20-25 years is we haven't thought about the needle that goes into the kidney and take out the tissue. Now there is an improvement in the needle itself, not only as Bhasa was saying, it is now coaxial, but also it has got a little bit of jacket in it and it is spring loaded. Now these two things are providing something which is against seedling. So the thought behind not using the needle percutaneously for biopsy is perhaps it will cause seedling. But now with the improved technique and the equipment, the seedling is, I think, negligible if at all it is there. So there are many plus points now.
About small renal masses, the biopsies are still underutilized. Most of the urologists, even across America and England, they were not in the favor of biopsies because they were think that it might not change the management of the patient, and you are adding something that is delaying the surgery and may provoke some kind of complication. So the biopsies are only reserved in US and England, where they are working in a tertiary care hospital or university-based hospital. So they were doing biopsies in every small renal mass, irrespective whether it is RCC or some kind of oncocytoma. So, but rest of the those who were practicing privately, or they were not doing in the biopsies.
I think one of the reasons is earlier there was only one treatment for a renal mass, and that is surgery. It was a very long held belief that there is no chemotherapy, or the tumor is not sensitive to chemotherapy, as well as it is radio resistant, so there is no radiation therapy for the tumor, and that is renal tumor. So when that statement was actually holding the whole scene, nobody was thinking in terms of doing something to know the identity of tumor. Yes, 90% of the tumors, or maybe more than that, are RCCs, but there are many variations in it. For instance, a chromophobe or a chromophile, these are two different kind of tumors. Similarly, the papillary variant is a different kind of a tumor. So now with understanding and the availability of other treatment protocols, for instance, as it was also mentioned, the heat ablative procedures, radio frequency ablation, the results of radio frequency ablations are as good as having ablative surgery like nephrectomy. And it is also used for those who which are very small tumors. But then you have to first identify and confirm that this is a tumor. So if it is a small renal mass, maybe less than 4 centimeter, then you have to prove with biopsy that it is a tumor, it is malignant, and then you can go on to have a radio frequency ablation. Same goes maybe in future for cryotherapy also. So all these therapies which are coming up, plus the immunotherapy and the understanding of tumor biology, now the scene is quite interesting. The same, it is the same as you compare it with the prostate. Now there are many options for prostatic treatment, prostatic malignant treatment, and these options or treatment options will always require a clinician to judge and understand at which stage the patient is and what kind of treatment the patient needs. So it is not only radical prostatectomy or radiotherapy. Now there are many things in the context of prostate. Same goes with renal tumor. So probably renal tumor in the context of management comes very late, but it is not something which is of interest in the next 5 years, because what the prediction with a lot of trials is, maybe we will not be able to do surgery for a lot of patients. Maybe we'll be able to manage them with certain new adjuvant therapies that are coming up. These are all maybes now, and they will be quite substantial in future. So rather than just killing or taking out the whole kidney for the purpose of doing away with a maybe 4 centimeter tumor in an 11 centimeter or 10 centimeter kidney, now this is something which is not on. So our journey towards treating malignancy in a kidney is going many ways. The one way for which surgical management is required is to do a lot of partial nephrectomy so that we have to save the nephrons. The whole concept and the philosophy is now changed. We have to save the nephrons and we have to ensure that there is oncological clearance. So if you do oncological, do a clearance which is slightly less than what is required, meaning to say there are positive margins, then this is of no use, because you are just leaving behind a lot of malignant tissue, and that will give rise to disease later on. So the first thing that we should always remember is to have oncological control proper. The next thing is we have to conserve tissue as much as possible. By conservation, I mean nephron sparing. So a person who needs treatment now, we have to look for the next 20 years or 30 years or for that person, how that person is going to react to lesser nephrons that we just provide to him or her now. So maybe it is like 30 years of age at which you want to do management. Maybe it is like 60 years of age. So the age range is also now changed all over the world. It is not a tumor which is a fifth decade tumor now. You might see it in early phase of life, maybe 25 years, 30 years of age. So a lot of change has been seen, and a lot of good work has been done. So we'll see a lot of positive messages coming on. That, yes, and that comes to another point in which we are working, on which we are working, and that is revision of urology curriculum for residents at the level of College of Physicians and Surgeons. What we propose, and that will be implemented in maybe next year's time, is to have this kind of skill which is mandatory for all urological residents, prostate biopsy as well as kidney biopsy. So we are doing bladder biopsy by means of cystoscopy. These two important organs are left behind. They should be with the in consonance, again, in consultation with radiologists, but it has to be learned and done by a urologist. So in next generation of residents will, I think, do it themselves.
When we are talking about the biopsy, the main reason behind them is to find out the tumors who are chemosensitive, basically, to like lymphoma. So if the, we are suspecting any other tumor other than RCC on a radiological imaging and biopsy is inconclusive, then what to do? So we repeat the biopsy or should we proceed for the partial or...
Yes. You see, first of all, you have to take care of these patients with a small renal mass definition, maybe less than 4 centimeter, away from the general pool. General pool means the general clinic in which they are seen. So you first of all see them separately. So that is a separate clinic for a small renal masses. Then you devise your strategy, whether you want to do away, or whether you want to have an answer through one session of biopsy or 2 sessions of biopsy. Now that is something for everybody to look into. I don't know whether there is anything in the guidelines as to have a repeat biopsy. But again, as Pardeep was saying, it depends upon the level of doubt that you have. If you think, for instance, the radiologist says that it is oncocytoma, but theoretically there is a 20% chance of having renal cell carcinoma along with oncocytoma. And if you are in the process of thinking in that direction, you are justified to have maybe 2 biopsies apart from one from each other. At 6 months interval, for instance. But again, you have to see this patient separately. Give that patient a separate status. Give that patient a required time just to understand yourself and understand his position or her position, because the person is carrying something which has got a doubt. You can't just let that person go away and you don't want to see that person. So first you create a space in your own healthcare system, in your own hospital and your clinics, and then you will be able to justify your position as having, for instance, repeat biopsy. So that is my take on the subject. I don't want to lose any pathology, anyone who has got some doubt. You have to clear the doubt and don't jump onto the conclusion, spastic conclusions, that no matter what happens, I'll just take out the half the kidney doing a partial nephrectomy and putting that person on my list of partial nephrectomies. That will not solve the problem. That might solve one of my egos that I have done a lot of partial nephrectomies, but that is not the way forward. We have to look for some guidelines and strategies to have a broader plan for next 5 years perhaps, or 10 years. Because you see, at the stage at which you are, apart from our resident group, You have to make some plans. You have to make some plans for yourself, and you have to make some plans for your own good, your own community. It's not one hospital or one city that counts. It's the whole nation or the whole region that counts. So please act locally and think globally. That is the slogan that we have. But please think at least regionally, if not globally. Let's have some plans. Let's have some opening of minds and do something for our people. Because you see, what we have different from the rest of the world is this kidney tumor in our series is the next at the second position. It is not the first oncological tumor, but it is the second oncological tumor in our series. As compared to the West, they have got prostate cancer as number one tumor. We have got bladder tumor as number one tumor. So we are if not totally, we are slightly different. And statistically, we stand at some other point. So you always think in those terms, as I have said earlier on. Please act locally and think at least regionally.